In today's video, I'll go through my top 20 learnings as a software engineer tech lead. The first one being the importance of clear planning and prioritization of your projects. These are essential, especially in the early phases of an initiative. Well-defined projects with solid goaling metrics and well-defined ownerships go a long way. But don't plan too much. Healthy balance is the secret. If your organization is fast-moving and dynamic, excessive planning can have the deleterious effect that little execution is actually done, since most of the time is spent planning. Third is that design docs are a valuable vehicle to crystallize how a complex system or process can be implemented. They incentivize the owner to structure their thoughts, are made stronger by receiving feedback from peers, and are a great source of documentation down the line. Then, if you realize that you've rehashed the same discussion 3 or 4 times, look into your organization's objectives. Find the commonalities from 5 of your organization's design docs, combine them all together, and you have material for a strategy. Then, when the future is too hazy to identify investments worth making, grab 5 strategies, combine them with your organization's objectives, and write a vision for 2 to 3 years out. Number 5 is that the best way to increase impact is by scaling oneself. In my case, I encountered my speed limit when trying to solve a critical path project, while at the same time attempting to set the direction for the team. As much as I pushed through, I was the bottleneck. At this point, it was clear that in order to increase impact, unblock our team, achieve our objectives, and have a balanced workload, I would need to scale myself. To scale through delegation, you can use the 75-25 rule. So if you are 75% certain that someone will correctly execute a given project or task, then delegate. The other 25% are the unknown space that the person needs in order to learn, explore, make errors, and innovate. In other words, grow. And if you are 100% certain they will be successful, they will not grow. On the other hand, if the probability of success is too low, then it will be frustrating and probably will not be completed, thus jeopardizing the team's objectives. And by default, don't micromanage. When delegating a task or project, give enough space for the delegatee to own it. In general, the objective is to clearly define expectations, areas of ownership, agree upon which details you should be kept up to date, which meetings you should attend, and which situations you expect to be pinged for escalations. Micromanaging only makes sense in very specific situations, such as when there is a high possibility of a major failure and help is needed to firefight and course correct. Number 8, if you're not failing, you're not pushing hard enough, and probably not growing. The 75-25 rule can be applied to yourself as well. So if you find to easily execute projects with a high degree of predictability, then look for bigger challenges. In other words, aim for a growth mindset rather than the fixed mindset. 9, making errors is completely okay and expected. They are part of the 25% above. Strive for them to only happen once though, otherwise they'll fail to serve their learning purpose. 10 is that one of the best ways to learn how to support projects is to mentor a new joiner. This will give you the opportunity to develop your interpersonal and project managing skills and will consolidate your knowledge about team and its position in the company. And having good mentors is one of the best ways to quickly grow and learn. Every new mentor will have something novel to teach you. They provide you with a golden path that you can follow to cut through the exhausting search for viable solutions to a given problem. 12. Learn from others outside your organization. For example, books are a good source of this knowledge, and I would recommend The Manager's Path, from which I extracted many of my base understandings of what a tech lead should be, do, and behave. 13 is to reach out to your peers. I was struggling to find the right balance between personal impact and directional impact, and my manager, original mentor, and the fellow experienced tech lead, they all helped me to tackle this and other challenges that came along the way. 14 is that goaling against quantifiable metrics will provide you with solid prioritization and justification. So make sure that your projects are goaled against an objective quantifiable metric. Otherwise, it will be hard to prioritize and justify their value during planning and execution to your peers and stakeholders. And clear and quantifiable goals increase motivation. Projects with an ambiguous value proposition are frustrating, and will receive less attention and effort from everyone involved because it won't be clear how impactful directions will actually be. 16 is to measure your personal progress by asking for candid feedback. If your manager and peers don't provide it at the moment, ask for this feedback explicitly. It's one of the best ways to measure the progress on your role and surfacing any blind spot you might have. Remember that without measurement, you're flying blind. 17. What you transmit and how matters. Written and oral communication are essential when explaining the rationale behind an objective, project, or task, and when coordinating with your peers and other stakeholders. This is a skill that can be learned. The best way to improve it, as I have found, is to write more, speak more, make more presentations, and study the communication methods from others. 18 is that most communication styles benefit from a news article structure. For example, having a TLDR first, then overall context of the problem and its impact, followed by the details such as delineation of a set of solutions, ending with the call to action or further questions. 19 is imposter syndrome, which might stem from a mismatch between perceived performance and expectations. To tackle this, you can work with your manager to explicitly define expectations and ask your manager and peers for explicit feedback to calibrate your perceptions. If you feel like an imposter, odds are you're not. As a side note, this links quite nicely with MOGO, that's happiness equation, which is that your happiness is equal or greater than the difference between the events of your life and the expectations of how life should be. Last but not least, take care of your body and mind. They are your ultimate tools. Exercise, eat healthy food, nourish your relationships, and strive for quality sleep. These are the essential tenets that will sustain all of the points above. I hope these learnings can be useful for your personal journey, and feel free to leave a comment below with your thoughts. I would be happy to know them. And with this, see you on the next one.